up, YouTube? I am getting ready to start a 722 at night right now. I just did a repair, which you can't see, and I'm getting ready to clean four rooms of carpet and a closet. Not really dirty, it's a frise. So the main reason for the cleaning is the client was concerned about pet dander. So really, you know, what I put together the pre-spray a little different. The pH is kind of low. I raised up the peroxide quite a bit so it can oxidize anything, you know, organic. And also added a pretty healthy shot of sodium chloride to it as well. So if there's any odors, it'll get knocked out. You know, I don't smell pet odor at this point because, you know, 22 years into it, your nose finally quits working, so you don't really notice it. But let's take a look. I'm going to try to cover some of this. Not really any time for video right now, but we're doing it anyway because that's kind of like my deal here. So hang on. Let's take a look. All right. Here is this. She was telling me it was like a double, but I'm not going to consider it a double. I'm going to consider it just one big room. You know, I guess I'm just cool like that. All right, here we go. Closet right here. I'm thinking that door was probably added later. I'll show you what I mean. Anyway, pull around here. Challenger, $250 off until December 31st, plus my $100 rebate. Here we go. Right there. The washroom, you can go straight through and you're back in the bathroom again. So anyway, not a lot of houses have that. So I'm thinking that was probably done after the fact. Anyway, like deja vu, isn't it? What's up, Challenger? All right, back around the corner again. We got a room here. It's not really anything going on major at all. We got another room here. Not really, a little bit of soil in there. You know, not an issue. If it's a frise and you got fairly difficult soil in it, it's harder to clean than most carpets are. Right here, a little bit of something going on right here. Everything I see is organic, so it's not a problem. There are no dyes related to it. So anyway, peroxide is the major player in this one here right now. So I guess I'm gonna set up the camera and make this room here kind of basically the one that it's all about. And we'll just kind of follow what's going on in the other room. What's funny is I've been on YouTube for so long now, since 2017. I've got, I don't know, excuse me for the way I'm filming like this right now, but this is real world work. I'm not setting up some strange situation here where I'm in a lab trying to tell people how to clean carpet. I'm out here working. Anyway, guy just commented about a video I put up yesterday where I keep in mind there's well over 2,500 videos on the channel, and I've been up since 2017, been in business for 22 years. Guy makes some comment about the amount of pre-spray that I put down on one of yesterday's jobs and said, well, I hope it doesn't wick back. You know, I'm not on here putting up videos because I don't know what I'm doing. I'm not seeking advice from anybody. I'm here to help people that need it. So whenever somebody drops a snide, nasty comment, all that's gonna get you is blocked and removed. So your comment will remain for all of about a minute before I block you and I remove you. This is my livelihood. You know, anytime you come around, you know, and you're trying to insult someone's livelihood, I put everything I have into my cleaning. You know, I'm not doing this because I'm on Home Advisor and all those other ones, and they're sending me work. I'm doing this by word of mouth, you know, and 22 years in the business, people know me. So, you know, I have a reputation to uphold when I come to someone's house and do the work. And, you know, I'm showing you all this because I enjoy the results, not because I'm trying to hide anything. You can watch everything I'm doing here. Anyway, off to work. All right, let me, we're gonna do this one in real time. there. This is something that I do sometimes. I get these guys out of the way by doing this. We're going to prime the sprayer. Go fairly quickly. Normally I would start over there and work back, but I'll do it opposite right now. All right, here we go. is going pretty quick compared to the amount of time it usually takes for me to do some carpet. Every once in a while you run into one that's not just torn up. Even after a vacuum, I'm still finding cat hair. Even cat hair is really fine, and it'll get wound up in the fibers where you can't vacuum it out. The thing with orbital cleaning is it orbits the towel through the carpet and it brings it up and it makes it in little balls like this so you can pick it up. So we'll get out of there. A little bit soiled. And remember, get your gliders. Now, if I can get that fan turned on, it'd be good. Yep. In all honesty, wicking used to be a problem until I switched to VLM cleaning and changed my chemical composition up quite a bit. From 01 to 06, I cleaned with a Hydromaster and an RX20. And just about every time you did a Berber, you would know that you would have to come back the next week and correct something. And generally, when you correct it, you do it VLM style. So, Why not just go to VLM cleaning and beginning and end right there and be done with it? I haven't had anything wick since 2006. And the odds are the guy that commented might not have even been born in 2006, for all we know. You know, all it takes to clean carpet is a job with a carpet cleaning company. You don't have to know what you're doing. There's no license required for this. All right, I'm going to just clean these two rooms and we'll come back and take a look. Just to speed things up, and then the last room, probably do it in time lapse. So, here we go. Gonna make up some time here. All right, those two rooms are done now. Take a quick look in here. Got a fan here, so that's gonna stay on, and we'll turn the light off. Here we go. And this one, there is no fan, so we'll just turn the light off. Now, Got one room to go. Maybe I'll do this one in full, in real time. Maybe. All right. I'll be right back. And we will begin. Like I said, this one here, the only spot is basically right over there. It's where it's holding any sizable amount of soil at all. I'll grab my ammonia right quick. Most of the time, whenever I got the ammonia, is when carpet guys and other cities start whining and start commenting all crazy. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and do this one in real time here, just because it's so small. Knock this one out. All the areas over there where I had most of the soil, that looks a whole lot better just from putting ammonia on it. Now we're gonna extract it. That's what you're looking for. Now we're gonna go take a look at everything I've already done here. And we'll close out the video. 8:30 now. Alright. Now what I need to do is turn just the light off and not the fan. Alright, I'm gonna leave that one on. Ambiance, maybe. That's what we'll call it, ambiance. Right, moving along here. You don't have a Royal, you're gonna need to get you one. Those are remarkable vacuums. Closet. And the light is over there. Man. All right, we'll take a quick look here. I already looked at that. We'll look at it one more time. Actually, I'm gonna take pictures of these and send them to my client. They are driving across the United States somewhere. This place is for sale. They contacted me about one repair, and I said, "Yeah, I can help you. And if you want it clean following the repair, I can do that as well." And they go, "We do need it clean." That's cool. All right, guys, that finishes up another video here. I'm gonna pack up all my toys here and head home, and I'm gonna try to put this video up tonight. The one I did earlier where I stretched the carpet, I probably won't put that one up tonight. I don't know. Anyway, it just depends on how much energy I have when I get to the house, and I don't know, it probably won't be a bunch. You know, I remember, you know, like 15 years ago, I'd go out and I'd work like this all day, and then about 11 o'clock, I would, put on my gym clothes and go to the gym and work out. You know, I don't have that in me anymore. I don't know. You know, I'm getting close to 50 here now. So, you know, the energy that you have when you're young, you need to really take advantage of that, you know, and work really hard in your 30s. Because when you get to your 40s and your 50s, it's gonna be harder. It'll be harder. So, you know, a lot of advice I could give you, even on relationships. You know, I can tell you exactly what not to do, you know. Anyway, this channel here is basically about me helping the little guy, the new guy, the sole proprietor. You know, when you enter this, you know, it's a little bit vicious because, you know, the only people you're really going to meet is people that want to sell you their wares. You know, are they there to train you? Not really. What they're there to do is to move product off of their shelf. And you can generally tell this by when you know, these guys in these groups that ask you, you know, that you ask questions to that are selling something, you know, you ask them, "Hey, how do you get this out?" The answer is always gonna be a product that they sell, you know. With me, you ask me how to get this out, I'm gonna point you toward either ammonia or hydrogen peroxide, which is products that everybody sells, you know. There's no patent on ammonia or peroxide, you know, so nobody really makes any money off of that, you know, in any of these carpet shops, you know, so they're not going to recommend that to you. I guarantee you 110% chance they're not going to recommend that to you, because you can buy it anywhere but there. So think about that, you know, and you can test me on this. You can call up somebody tomorrow or whenever and go, "Hey, how do you get this out?" And it's going to be something that they sell. And you can ask them something about, would ammonia work or would peroxide work? The answer is going to be no. The only thing I can't tell you is the reason why. But the reason why is because they don't make any money off it when they sell it to you. So they're not going to recommend that. You know, it's only logical. You know, if they can sell you something, they're going to sell you something. I'm not really here to sell you anything. So I don't care, you know. And basically, as far as, like, you know, me being right or wrong, or basically the need to be right, I don't need to be right when I give this advice. I don't care if you believe me or not. You know, I'm not here lying to you, but, you know, if you don't believe what I say is true, then just dismiss it. It's all the same to me. You know, I'm here to help a few people. And if I can help a few people, then karma's in my favor. But no, I don't, you know, like I had a gentleman, we'll call him a gentleman I was talking to, I guess last week or something. We're talking about gliders, you know, and I was telling him about the gliders and explaining stuff. And he says, I disagree. I'm like, well, I'm fine with that. Let's not talk so much. How about that? You know, you don't even need to watch the channel. You know, if you think that everything I'm telling you is a lie, then don't watch the channel. But the unique thing about that is that your haters watch first. Odd how that works. Your haters watch first. And everybody on YouTube has haters. Luckily, I've met enough really, really, really good guys that it makes it worth my while to still help. If you have questions, you can put them in the comment section. If you're interested in purchasing a Challenger, you're welcome to text me. It's 512-350-1129. And, you know, different from other dealers, you know, when you buy a Challenger from me, you know, I obviously get a commission check. So what I do is I take $100 out of the commission check and send it to you as a thank you. You can call around and see if you can find another dealer that's willing to do that for you. Odds are, no, you're not going to find that. Then furthermore, when you're out and you have questions, you know, I'm basically a text away, you know. So a guy just bought one last week from me, and he got it, and he's been texting questions like every day, and I stop and I help him, you know. Try that with your dealer, you know. Get their personal cell phone number. Say, hey, I need your personal cell phone number so I can text you questions when I'm out in the field and have questions. You're not going to get that. You're going to get that anywhere else. Here is the only place you're going to get that. So, you know, if that level of help is worth something to you, that's something that I can provide that these other dealers that deal in other brands, and they're not going to give that to you. So everything I said is true, but you're welcome to dismiss it. So anyway, thanks for watching, guys, and God bless. I'll see you on the next video.